So the Apple Vision Pro is both a fantastic content consumption, but also creation device. And in this video, we're gonna be talking about the most requested comments and messages I've gotten in the past week. And that has to do with the color accuracy of the displays. Now real quick, the other day I posted some cool pictures that me and Michelle took with the Apple Vision Pro. Right now, if you head over to my Instagram, follow me and comment on that post something like, let me try that preset. I'll go ahead and send it to you so you can test out on your own photos. Tag me, let me know what you think of it. All right, back to the Vision Pro and color accuracy. So very quickly, we can find the tech spec for the screens and the color accuracy of the Vision Pro. And we see it covers 92% of the DCI P3 color space. And that's about 985 million colors out of the 1.07 billion that P3's total color range is. So when I reached out to my friend Kazi, who is by far one of the best professional colorists out there working in all sorts of movies and commercial projects, and actually has one of the best colorist YouTube channels on this platform, I reached out to get some incredible insight, and this is the message that he had. Okay, so maybe professional Hollywood level colorists aren't gonna be selling their $30,000 reference monitors anytime soon. And if one of the questions or things you're thinking about is, could I calibrate this screen in the future like any other monitor out there? Well, there's some very passionate people in the colorist subreddit who ask the same question and are giving very colorful answers to this. But the short answer is no. It's not really an easy way to calibrate this headset. But what about the rest of us? Let's get real for a second here. Most of us are content creators, hobbyists. There's quite the spectrum of creative professionals out there who want something that is color accurate. You know, you don't want to spend all this time editing and grading, send it off to a client and have the colors be extremely all over the place. So let's get a battery connected on this guy and dive right in. All right, so now we're inside Vision Pro and let's get Lightroom opened up. Siri, open Lightroom. So these are some of the photos that I posted to Instagram the other day. I'm really excited to start getting back into still photography. I've missed doing it. So these are some of the Vision Pro photos that are over on Instagram you can check out. All right, so let's go ahead and edit one of these that I didn't edit the other day. Ah, this one should make people angry with the cable and everything. All right, so right off the bat, the raw photo, everything looks great. Like the colors, the natural tones, and the dynamic range of this headset honestly is just impressive. And it's just as impressive because it feels like an Apple display. Grab this guy here. And first, let's go ahead and apply that LUT that, if you guys follow me on Instagram, I'll send you. I believe currently it's listed as cold blue, kind of different variations, maybe blue green. I don't know. Which one do you guys like more? Comment down below. Do you like the blue green one? Or cold blue right off the bat. I don't know. So I'm just gonna hit done down there. And then we're gonna get our main setting. So I'm gonna go under light. I'm gonna look at exposure. And what's nice is once I grab my tool and once I have a hold of it, I can look back at my image and fine tune it to what I want. Raise the highlights just slightly. Now I wanna clean up the reflections right here. So I'm gonna bring it nice and close. I'm gonna tap on the heel. Let's see what our brush size is working with here. So I'm going to go right there. Got my gestures, pinch and grab, and I can feel like Tony Stark. So make this huge. I love this. This feels like my dream Wacom tablet. And so our brush size is too small since we zoomed in. So I'm going to use a bigger one here. This one may be too big. Honestly, the processing is pretty quick. I mean, I know it's a nice M2 chip in there. I can totally understand a lot of people not liking this. There is something to say about having a physical, tactical response when you're using like an Apple Pencil on an iPad. I think like hardcore professionals are still gonna go that route for a little bit. For someone like me, this is definitely a more fun experience. By the way, most of the photos, I had hair issues like this where my hair was stuck underneath the light seal. So Photoshop Generative Fill to fix that issue. So yay. Let's also see if we can get this mic out of the way. And the cool thing about this is you can very quickly see it at different sizes. So maybe you're someone who's gonna print these out and put it on the wall. I could very easily make this full screen and be like, oh, okay, it looks like that at this you know, smaller like iPad screen size. Maybe it's gonna be nice and small on the wall, or it's gonna be this like wall size canvas. I can stretch it out. You're gonna tell me that doesn't look good? As long as this screen recording is a fair representation of what I'm seeing. Oh, look, I forgot I left my photos over there from earlier. As someone who got a fairly high score on a how many colors can I see test, I can tell you that this is a very accurate screen. But let's jump over to DaVinci Resolve and see how that is working. And we're gonna start with the connected to Mac. So we see our Kinect pop up. We should get our computer monitor. All right, so if I grab this guy. All right, so we'll just grab this 12 second clip that was shot on the 15 Pro Max. So we'll head over to our color page, add in a couple serial nodes. All right, so for our conversion, we're gonna add our one LUT iPhone 15, which makes it look like an Airy. I really, really wish we could do multiple desktops or something so I have a clean feed. Obviously, I can make this nice and large. So there is that. Maybe add in a little bit of a feather here and maybe boost the saturation. Again, I've color graded, you know, obviously in my studio with the iPhone a ton. I know what this LUT looks like. So to me, this looks great. And if I open up Siri Open Safari, head over to YouTube, and we go watch my latest video here. So when I watch this, the colors look great. I think what may throw people off is the opaqueness of the windows. Like you're using, like I'm looking at a screen, essentially of a screen of content where, you know, there's the foveated rendering, which it's not perfectly lifelike. And then this window, depending on where I place it, like if I put it up against like this solid back wall, it looks more like a monitor. It's not really see-through and stuff, but if I put it over by where like this light is, and you have that, you're introducing kind of these layers of thing of real life things and digital things, and it kind of confuses these eyes. It's kind of the reason like you're not supposed to edit in like a crazy lit environment, is because it's going to ruin kind of how your eye is perceiving these different colors. So really one of the extra benefits to the Vision Pro, Joey Helms actually talked about in his video he just uploaded, is imagine right now I'm at a coffee shop, or I'm outside, or I'm somewhere that's not a controlled studio environment. Well, you're gonna introduce a lot of different, you know, maybe the sunlight is putting a glare on your screen or whatever, and you're not gonna be able to get this nice, really kind of confined, proper lit area to color grade. Well, how you can do that is by turning your digital crown and put yourself in an environment. So right now I'm somewhere in the woods. I forget what this location is called, but it doesn't really matter. It's nighttime. So I could be in broad daylight in real life. And so now when I bring this close to me, I'm not having any color or light leaks or weird glares. I'm seeing this footage exactly how I should be. And that is a huge advantage if you are constantly traveling or you don't have the perfect studio color grading environment. And same thing if I'm watching my example video here. All right, and so now let's take a look at what this stuff is looking like on the actual computer screens. So obviously we have the DaVinci Resolve open here. And if I head back to this page, colors, the light levels, you know, anything that was the amount of clipping or close to clipping or crushing the blacks, like it's all extremely accurate. Yes, there is technically less colors on the Vision Pro than on, say, the iPad Pro, which is 100% the P3 color space. And I think the same goes for the MacBook Pros. These are technically better displays than the Vision Pro. But anyone who tries to use that as a con that isn't someone like Kazi, in my opinion, it's a useless argument, because for most of us who are creating content for the internet, which exists, you know, mostly in an sRGB color space, which is way less than even the 92% coverage of the Vision Pro, it's not a big enough difference to where you're going to be able to tell. The only reason I would suspect you wouldn't want to, say, edit photos on the Vision Pro is if you just didn't like the interface. If you want that kind of tactical touching an iPad or using a keyboard and mouse, and you don't want to use like the native version of Lightroom where you're touching the air. And if you don't like that, then fine. But in terms of color accuracy, it looks very good. But as always, I would love to hear if you agree or disagree in the comments below. And if you haven't seen my first video on the Apple Vision Pro, where I talk about is this good for video editors and what that workflow and pros and cons of all that good stuff is like, check out this video right up here. I think I pointed to the wrong area. I think it's over here. But regardless, subscribe, watch the video, all that. I appreciate you. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.
Butchered that outro.